God is able to do just what he said he would do. He's gonna fulfill. He's gonna fulfill every promise to you. Don't give up. Don't give up on God, 'cause he won't. 'Cause he won't. He's able. Sing it with me. Oh, 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 he's able. He's able. Sing it. Oh, 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 God is able. God is able to do just what he said he would do. He's gonna fulfill. He's gonna fulfill every promise to you. Don't give up. Don't give up on God, 'cause he won't. 'Cause he won't give up on you. He's able. Sing it with me. Oh, come on. Oh, oh, he's able. He's able. He's able. He's able this morning. He's able. He's able. He's able. He's able. My God is able. Your God is able. Yes, he's able. Yes, he's able. Yes, he's able. Glory to God. Me and Pastor Amy cover you this morning. We want you to know your God is able. I pray that the Holy Ghost would touch you. I pray that the Holy Ghost would equip you. I pray that the Holy Ghost would lead you, guide you, direct you, order your steps. I pray that the Holy Ghost would establish you. I pray that the Holy Ghost would lead you to a breakthrough. I pray that the Holy Ghost would lead you to victory. Jesus said, upon this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. God, I thank you for bringing your people out more than conquerors, no matter how bad the situation may look. God can still turn it around in the name of Jesus. Oh, glory to God. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Mighty God, mighty God. I want to talk to you this morning about you're getting a breakthrough. As we continue in our series, your trouble has God's attention. You're getting a breakthrough. I said you're getting a breakthrough. You're getting a breakthrough. Glory to God. We declare the word over your life. You're getting a breakthrough. Hallelujah. Bless his name. This brings us to the book of 2 Samuel chapter 5. Beginning at verse 17 through 25, the Bible says, "But when the Philistines heard that they had anointed David king over Israel, all the Philistines came up to seek David, and David heard of it and went down to the stronghold." Dear God, I want you to know something. The anointing attracts trouble. Promotion attracts trouble. Trouble. In fact, it provokes an attack by the enemy. When Satan sees God elevating you and anointing you and giving you greater responsibilities in the kingdom of God, you now have a bigger target on your back. He will try to do everything in his power to undermine you, to shut you down, to stop you. Are you listening to me? To intimidate you, to make you turn away from the call of God. And the Bible says this is what happened. David had just freshly been anointed to reign over all of Israel now. At first he started reigning over Judah, but now God is promoting David. And when the Philistines heard that he was anointed over all of Israel, the Bible says they came to seek David. They wasn't looking looking for him to give him gifts. They were looking for him to do him in. They were gathering together to just wreck his life. Come on, somebody. But David was smart. The Bible says David went down to the hole. Your stronghold is Jesus. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run therein and they are safe. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. David said, God will hide me in his presence from the pride of men. Oh, glory to God. Did you know the presence of God is an armor and a protection against the pride of men and their attacks? Oh, bless his holy name this morning. Now watch this. The Philistines also came and spread themselves in the valley of Rephaim. And David was smart. He did this the same thing that this is where Jehoshaphat got it from. David was his forefather. This is where King Asa got it from. And David inquired of the Lord, saying, shall I go up to the Philistines? Will you deliver them into my hand? And the Lord said unto David, go up, for I will doubtless deliver the Philistines into your hands. God's guaranteeing somebody under the sound of my voice this morning. God is guaranteeing you a breakthrough. He is guaranteeing you victory. He is guaranteeing you a win. Oh, blessed be his name. Listen, God said to David, I will doubtless deliver the Philistines into your hand. You've been wondering how the situation is going to turn out. That same stacked against you. You coming out on top. You coming out victorious. You coming out more than a conqueror. Listen to what the Bible says in verse 20. And David came to Baal Perazim. My God, my God. And David smote them there and said, the Lord has broken forth upon my enemies before me as the breach of waters. Therefore he called the name of that place Baal Perazim. Baal Perazim means the place of the breakthrough. I'm here to tell somebody, you have come to a place where God is about to give you a breakthrough. David said, he prepares a table before me in the presence of his enemies. My God, my God. They crucified Jesus. They buried him in a borrowed tomb. And the Pharisees were celebrating and rejoicing. They thought it was over. They even placed guards to watch the tombs because they said, you know, this deceiver said in 3 days he's coming back. But they couldn't stop the resurrection. On the third day, the Spirit of God raised him from the dead. And Jesus said to his apostles and disciples, all power is given unto me in heaven and on earth. Go into all the world and preach the gospel. I said, you're getting a breakthrough in the name of Jesus. And I love this because verse 21 says, David beat them so bad that they left their images, and David and his men burned them. Those images were idol gods that the Philistines used to work witchcraft. They were used to getting the victory by witchcraft, but they ran into a man full of the Holy Ghost. They ran into a man who had God on his side. They ran into a man whom the Lord would fight his battles, and God helped David to beat the devil out of him. My God. Beat them so bad they left their witchcraft and idol gods and ran for their life. Come on, somebody. And David took their idol gods that they used to work witchcraft, and David and his men burned them. I dare someone to lift your hands to heaven and say, the spell is broken. The curse is broken. The witchcraft is broken. Oh, they may try to work it against you, but it can't work. You are covered in the blood. My God, Galatians 3:13 and 14 says, Jesus Christ became a curse for us, because the word of God declares curses everyone who hangs on a tree, that the blessing of Abraham may come on the Gentiles through Jesus Christ. My God, you will get a breakthrough. God is on your side. God is helping you fight your battles. No hex, no spell, no dust thrown, no graveyard dust. Let him get a piece of your clothes and plant it in the graveyard. It can't work against you. God is on your side. And if God be for you, who can be against you? My God, this curse is broken. David and his men burned their witchcraft. They burned it. The curse is broken. Glory to God. Now watch this. Watch this. Pay attention now. Verse 22. And the Philistines came up yet again. Ah, this devil is persistent. Sounds like Luke 4 and Matthew 4, where the Bible says, and Satan taketh him, and Satan taketh him again. My God, when the devil was tempting Jesus, he tempted him for 40 days and 40 nights. That's 5.5 weeks, almost 6 weeks. Nonstop, he was on his case. The devil may be tempting you right now, but I got bad news for the devil. No weapon for against you will prosper. When the enemy comes against you like a flood, the Spirit of the living God will raise a standard against him. My God, so they came up yet again and spread themselves in the valley of Rephaim. And when David inquired of the Lord, he said, thou shalt not go up. I want you to do it different this time, David. But fetch a compass behind them and come upon them over against the mulberry trees. And let it be when you hear the sound of a going in the tops of the mulberry trees, that then thou shalt bestir thyself, for then shall the Lord go out before thee to smite the host of the Philistines. In other words, God was telling David, wait until you hear that my army of angels marching in the top of the mulberry trees. When you hear that detailed sound, when you hear the sound of the anointing of God moving, that's when you can launch your attack on the enemy, and I will annihilate them. But I just want you, wait on me, David. Don't go before me. Let me make my move first. And when I make my move, you make your move, and know that I'm going to give you the victory. And the Bible says in verse 25, and David did so. The 2 Samuel 5 verse 25, and David did so as the Lord had commanded him, and smote the Philistines from Geba until thou come to Gaza. David whipped them from the rising of the sun unto the going down of the sea. He whipped them until they could hardly recover themselves. And if this beating wasn't bad enough, David said, you know what? I feel like I'm only clipping the leaves off the tree. Every time I clip the leaves, they're growing back. David said, I need to get to the root of this thing. So David, in 2 Samuel chapter 8, David went to the hometown of the Philistines. He went to the headquarters of the Philistines, and David whipped them. David defeated them. David conquered them. David subdued them. He beat them so bad until the Bible says the Philistines begin to give David gifts. They begin to pay tribute to David. I'm telling you, God knows how to get honey out of the rock. God knows how to take what the devil meant for evil and turn it out to be a blessing in your life. I said, you're getting a breakthrough. I said, you are getting a breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody. In the name of Jesus. Come on, Holy Ghost. Because there is power in the name of Jesus. Power. Because there is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain. God broke the attack that came against David. I mean, God broke it and destroyed that witchcraft and subdued the Philistines to the point that they begin to bring gifts to David. God is turning your situation around. Join your faith with us. Main Pastor Amy, cover you. We cover your family. We cover your children. We cover your business, your ministry, your career. We cover everything you put your hands on. We cover you in the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. We pray divine protection over you and your loved ones, and we declare a breakthrough in the name of Jesus. You're getting a breakthrough. You're getting a breakthrough. You're getting a breakthrough. You're getting the victory. You are getting the victory. You're getting a breakthrough in the name of Jesus. You just need to begin to rejoice and give God the glory. Give him the honor. Give him the praise. God is on your side, and he wants you to know you're getting a breakthrough. You're getting a breakthrough. I hear the chains. I hear the chains. I hear the chains falling, falling right now. I hear the chains. Somebody shout, break chain. Sing it with me this morning. Break, come on. Chain, sing it. Break, chain. Break, chain. Break, 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 break. You got to break, you got to break. To break, to break every chain, break every chain. Glory to God, glory to God. I want you to stay right there in that flow. Somebody under the sound of my voice, you need to make things right with God. You know He loves you. He died on Calvary cross. He sent His only Son to die just for you. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. He loves you. Just lift your hands to heaven right now and say, Lord, I'm tired of running from You. I surrender my life to You. Forgive me of all of my sins. Wash me in Your blood. Save my soul. I believe You died on Calvary cross for me. They buried You in a borrowed tomb, but on the third day, God raised You from the dead. You are now seated at God's right hand. Soon and very soon, You're coming again. I surrender my life to You this morning. Not my will, but Your will be done. Thank You, Jesus, for forgiving me of my sins and saving my soul. If you just surrendered your life to Jesus, if you just made things right with God, I want you to type below this video. Put it in the comment section. Type below this video and said, I just surrendered my life to Jesus. We congratulate you, and we, me and Pastor Amy, welcome you into God's family. We welcome you into the kingdom of God. And listen, I want to give all of you, our viewing audience, an opportunity to stand with us. Support the preaching of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Stand with us as we declare the word of God. To support the work of God, you can visit us online right now at seanpinder.net/give. You can also give through the ministry PayPal account. That address is paypal.me/Sean Pinder Ministries. You can also text the give. All you have to do is text the letters SPM to the number 45888, and a link will automatically be sent to you. You can also give through the Ministry Zelle account. The Ministry Zelle email address is info@SeanPinder.net. You can also give through the Ministry Cash App account. The Ministry Cash App address is $SeanPinderMinistries. You can also mail your donations into the ministry. Just remember to make your checks and money orders out to Sean Pinder Ministries, P.O. Box 2726, McKinney, Texas 75070. And we are asking you, our social media family, help us reach 1 million people a month with the gospel of Jesus Christ. To do that, all we need you to do is share this video with at least 5 people. 5 of your friends and family members that you know need a word from God. You know they need a word of encouragement. Send it through WhatsApp, through Snapchat, through Facebook Messenger, LinkedIn, Twitter. Email that YouTube link out to some of your friends. Share it, share it, share it. Help me get this gospel around the world. We want to reach as many souls as we can before God calls us home. Help us preach this gospel around the world by liking, commenting, and sharing these videos. And also subscribing. We love you. God bless you. See you on tomorrow.